Hi, I'm Mark Lassoff. I've got a short JavaScript tutorial for you today on arrow functions. Arrow functions came with the ES6 version of JavaScript, and they're often a source of confusion. They are simply a new notation or syntax for traditional JavaScript functions. I'll admit, though, that if you're coming from another language or you're just starting out, the arrow functions can be a bit confusing. Let's take a look at the code. So here I've got a basic HTML structure that I've called arrow.html. And in the body, I've got a logical division called output and then script tags. Let's first take a look at a normal function written the traditional way. Probably the most traditional way to write functions in JavaScript is with the keyword function. And let's write a function called squareMe that takes a value and squares it, multiplies it by itself. So the way our function will work, it'll simply return value times value. So pretty simple function, and it's easy to understand what it does. So now that we've got the function and the function's implementation, we need a call to the function so the function actually operates. So let's go ahead and call squareMe, and we'll pass it a value 15. So that'll call the squareMe function, and it'll pass it 15. 15 will be multiplied by itself and returned. Since this function has a return, we need to do something with the value that's returned, so I'm gonna capture it in a variable called result, and then we'll output results to our output logical division on line 10. So we'll grab the logical division with document, get element by ID. We're getting the output element, and we're setting its inner HTML property to result. Now when I save, you can see the result in the browser, 225. By the way, I'm using VS Code, and I'm using a plugin that displays the result in the browser window immediately. So that's the most traditional way of doing the function. There's another way that's common that we're going to take a look at now. So instead of using the keyword function like this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to say squareMe equals function like that. So now everything else is the same. Notice when I save, the result here doesn't change. If I change the value that we're squaring to 9, now it changes to 81. So we know this code is working. This is another traditional way to create a JavaScript function, where we're assigning the function to the squareMe reference. We could also say here, for example, let squareMe. So we're declaring squareMe formally, and squareMe equals this particular function. Now, if we were to write this as an arrow function, it would look a little bit different. Let me take all this code that we've written so far, and I'm going to comment it out. So this way it's still there for reference. So now I'm going to write this as a simple arrow function. So in this case, it's still called squareMe, and we're going to use the equal sign and then the parentheses to indicate the parameter. In this case, value. And then we're gonna use the arrow, and our function returns value times value. And that is the whole function. The arrow operator is the key to all this. And on the right side of the arrow operator is our implementation. All right, so now that we've written the actual arrow function, let's take it out for a spin. We'll call it the same way. So again, I'm gonna create a result variable, and I'm gonna call the squareMe function, and I'll pass it this time the value 8. Doesn't really matter. We need to do something with the result. So again, we'll use document, get element by ID. We're getting the output element, and we're setting its inner HTML to result. And once again, we correctly execute the function, 8 is squared, and you see the value 64. Let's do a second example with a slightly more complex function. Let's do a function that has multiple lines in its implementation and takes more than one parameter. So let's create right below it a second function. So let's create right below the function that we created a second function. I'm going to call this one average. And this will average two values. So the parameters will be value 1 and value 2. And this time, after our arrow function, we'll create a code block with the curly brackets. So now we can put more than one line of code inside our function implementation. So the way we average is we'll add the two values together and then divide them by 2. So let the average equal value 1 plus value 2. And then we'll reassign the average divided by 2. Now, because we have multiple lines here, the return is not implicit. I actually have to use the return statement and return the average like that. If we look again at our first function on line 20, there's no return statement. The return is implicit. Whatever is to the right of the arrow function on a single line is returned. You see that in line 20. Because we have a multi-line function, inside of the curly brackets, we have to use the return statement explicitly. You physically have to see it in the function. So let's give our average function a whirl. Again, I'm going to use result. I'm going to call the average function, and let's pass it two values. Let's say 15 and 20. And now, again, I'll display the results, document get element by ID, inside the output div, that's the element we're getting. We'll set the inner HTML to result. And there we get 17.5. That's the average of 15 and 20. So this second function is more complex. It takes multiple parameters and it's multiple lines in its implementation. Now, of course, they didn't want to keep things simple, so there's a couple other ways that arrow functions can work. Check this out. Let's say we have an arrow function called greeting that takes a parameter called name. We can write it actually like this, equals name, which is our parameter, then the arrow is going to be hello plus name. So if we were to run that function call will look like this. And it's going to return hello mark in this case. So if we use our document get element by ID again, you can see the result. And we're getting the output again. And the inner HTML is equal to, let's call greeting and pass it a name. So that's going to pass the string mark up to the greeting function. That'll be assigned to name. Notice how we use the equal sign here. And then the implementation concatenates hello and the string mark. So when I save, there you see hello mark. Now, by the way, this also works without parentheses. So if I take the parentheses out here, it looks kind of strange, but let's change our call just so we're sure it's working to hello Brittany, which is the name of our illustrious production assistant today. And there you can see the text says, hello, Brittany. All right, I hope you enjoyed this short tutorial and that you now better understand JavaScript arrow functions. If you did enjoy the tutorial, do me a favor, hit that like button and subscribe and take a look at the links below. We do run an online learn to code program where we teach you everything you need to know to get to your first job in coding. It's just $9.95 a month. Can you imagine that? Thanks so much for watching. I will see you in the next video.